Recently, a high-intensity thunderstorm inflicted havoc in parts of Rajasthan and Uttar Pradesh, leaving at least 100 people dead and over 100 others injured. The thunderstorm has not only affected human life in these states but also affected solar farms. A video that went viral on social media shows how the storm debauched 100 gigawatt dream uprooting the solar plant in Rajasthan. The video compelled to rethink if India's solar dream can ever come true, compromising on the quality and design of our solar farms. We tried to get answer to our questions from the veterans of the Indian solar industry. Should the designing of the plant or the quality of the structure to be blamed? Here is what they said.
I think primarily it is a design of a structure, because in India normally people ignore these high intensity of wind, you know. So primarily I would rate this as it's a design fault.
It's basically, I will say that both the things are to be blamed. Looking into the first cut of that, because designing anyhow, whenever a plant is designed, the maximum wind speed is being considered for any structure design part of it. Similarly, the thickness and the raw material of the structure is also being considered, which I feel has not been taken care properly in this case.
Yeah, so in my opinion, just to give an assessment based on no data will be generally not fair. But the first thing to know is what were the wind speeds, what were the damage if done to fixed structure. Now, these structures are the tracking types, and on a preliminary basis, it seems to be under-designed.
See, recently you have gone through that video. If you'll have a look at that video,
right.
So the quality of the structure is very, very weak. So, see, these kind of things happen because in, if we talk about India, client is not quality conscious, the client is more towards price conscious. So, there is a lot of competition. If you know, if you will go through this solar industry, there are already more than 1500 to 2000 companies working in India. So there is very, very tough competition among this solar industry. Ab kya hota hai? Let's take an example. When we go to a customer, we tell them, sir, hum aapko is XYZ price mein aapko product denge. So there is a different company jo humse 5% ya 7% ya 10% lower prices pe quote kar deta hai. The thing is, jo prices pe lower quote karte hain, sometimes those prices are so aggressive, we don't believe it ki itne saste cost mein project kaise ho sakta hai. So those prices are just unbelievable. But jab saste price mein project pass hoga, see, customer ko wahan par awareness nahi hai. What customer feels is, let's take an example, humne customer ko 100 rupees mein koi project quote kiya aur samne se kisi company ne aake bola, sir, we'll give you the same project at 95 rupees. Tab customer ko ek feeling aata hai, bijli to ye bhi banayega aur bijli to 95 rupees wala system bhi banayega. So why should I pay something extra? 5% mein extra kyun pay karun? And when we talk about these big power projects, ab ek ek megawatt ki project cost hoti hai 4 crore, 5 crore ke aas paas. Aur usme 5-10% ka variation hona, it's a very big thing. Jo client ki pocket se jata hai. So client sochta hai ki electricity hi to banni hai. Us waqt client ko ye cheeze samajh nahi aati ki usme jab price se compromise karenge, to definitely quality of components, jaise अब इस रीसेंट केस में आप देखेंगे, इनमें दोनों ही केस में, एक आगरा वाले केस में और ये जो वीडियो है जो अभी वायरल हुआ था, इन दोनों ही केसेस में स्ट्रक्चर से कंप्रोमाइज हुआ है. एक मिनिमम अमाउंट ऑफ थिकनेस का स्ट्रक्चर होता है, पर्लिंस होता है, राफ्टर्स होता है, उनकी मिनिमम थिकनेस होनी चाहिए. तो उससे कंप्रोमाइज किया गया है. अब जब कॉस्ट कम लेंगे कहीं ना कहीं, तो ईपीसी कंपनी प्रोडक्ट परचेज करने में अपना कॉस्ट कटिंग करेगा ना.
Is it the result of intense unhealthy competition?
No, it's not like that. The intense competition is everywhere. Okay. It is more or less, I would say, the customers are like, you know, they are not very sensitive about the long durability of solar plant which are getting installed, you know. So the customers are asking for maybe the quality is compromised, you know, because of the price pressure. But at the same time, I mean, you know, this is a one of a case, like, you know, this kind of cyclone can damage anything. I mean, but still, you know, India should learn from this, and all existing plant and the upcoming plant, they should try to mitigate, and you know, they should try to strengthen those plants to avoid such situation. And upcoming plants, in fact, government also should come up with standards, very strict standard for the structure particularly, which can definitely reduce the chances of this kind of incidences.
No, that is definitely this is because of the unhealthy competition. The problem what is happening is people now are designing, trying to design as much low tonnage as possible for any solar structure. But most of the time what is happening is they are going wrong into their basic designing itself when you do the STAT analysis for that structure design part of it. So yes, definitely it is for this is because of this unhealthy competition, and because of the tariff going down and the rates are going so much down on that part.
See, the pressure of the reverse bidding and the cost cutting, and in some cases developers who wish to resell the property after a few years, those kind of things have definitely impacted the design as well as the quality in the execution. And I wouldn't deny that this is not a fact.
But definitely. See, there are companies like, we are also working in the market, Trilig Energy. Then there are companies like Race Power Infra. And if we talk about Tata, right? Then we have companies like Jackson. So these all are big players. ये एक quality product देते हैं, ठीक है? But अभी क्या हो रहा है? Because अब आपने देखा होगा, you have recently gone through this news. अब MNRE ने वो channel partner वाला भी system खत्म कर दिया है. So anyone can come into the solar power sector and go straight away to the client and tell them, sir, solar तो हम भी लगा के दे देंगे. But कोई accreditation नहीं है पीछे से. We all guys are MNRE approved channel partners. उन्होंने हमारा quality देखा, हमारा financial strength देखा, तब हमें एक MNRE approval दिया. उसके बाद क्योंकि हम MNRE approved हैं, तो हमारा एक काम करने का एक तरीका है. We work according to MNRE standards. But in projects में आप जो भी देखोगे, किसी MNRE standard पे काम ही नहीं हुआ है. तो unhealthy competition definitely है. क्योंकि अब what's happening in this solar power industry, कोई भी आके solar system लगाने लग जाता है. Without any prior expertise, without any prior information कि किस तरह का quality use होना चाहिए, किस तरह का component install होना चाहिए, without any expert team होती नहीं है. But what people do, दो तीन बंदों की team से अपना एक company शुरू कर लेते हैं, and then they go and pitch to any client, और project strike हो जाता है just because of lower prices. So project clear हो जाता है, and then this is the result.
Should the government and project developers start considering selection of project site location before starting the design stage?
I'm saying, so you cannot identify any location, because this can happen anywhere. Only thing is, at least, you know, the bad this kind of wind, you know, I mean, the system should be protected from this kind of wind. I mean, yeah, if it is more than that, 150, 180 kilometers, then okay, then only the God can save this. Otherwise, but at least 120, 100 kilometers, at least, you know, that can happen anywhere. So, wherever the new solar plants are getting installed, the strength and the stability of the structure should be considered along, with this kind of wind velocity.
No, I don't think that is the main issue, because thing is, whenever a project location has been selected, the maximum wind speed as well as other criteria are being considered during the plant design stage itself. So this is anyhow is being taken care when any project is getting started. So whenever a government or a project developer comes up with a project in a particular area, they take care of the wind speed, seismic zone, everything on that part before starting the design part of it.
So apart from the solar insulation, wind, soil data, earthquake zone, flooding, these are important parameters out of say 40 odd parameters available for site selection. Most of the sites available in this part of the country have definitely high insulation, so high energy yield availability. But soil and high wind velocity with the gusts that we are probably looking at now are definitely a one band. And it may probably add an extra 4-5% in the cost of the structure and the foundation, but this is indeed doable for all the advantages that you get in terms of lower cost of land and of course higher generation. So I wouldn't really say that somebody should do a due diligence. These are all good sites because it's a land which is available, is barren, is meant for solar radiation, for solar generation.
See, location in India, there is no location ki jahan pe is tarah ka hadsa na ho. But kya hota hai ki whenever we provide this structures, है ना, उसमें एक मिनिमम विंड स्पीड की गारंटी होती है, 120 किलोमीटर पर आर की विंड स्पीड खेल सकेगा. तो अगर 170 किलोमीटर पर आर की विंड स्पीड खेल सकता है, तो इंडिया में कहीं भी लगा सकता है और हादसे नहीं होंगे. जो मिस हैपनिंग से एक्सीडेंट आप जो भी बोलेंगे वो नहीं होगा. बट लोग बाग वो स्टैंडर्ड्स मेंटेन ही नहीं कर रहे हैं. सो लोकेशन से कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है कि गवर्नमेंट को लोकेशन से एक आइडेंटिफाई करना चाहिए कि इस जगह ये हो सकता है या इस जगह नहीं हो सकता है. राजस्थान में पहले भी बहुत पावर प्लांट्स है, बाकी तो नहीं खराब हो रहे हैं. आगरा में भी कितने पावर प्लांट्स लगे हुए हैं, अगर 100 लगे हुए हैं तो उसमें से एक दो में प्रॉब्लम आ रहा है. प्रॉब्लम इज जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ क्योंकि क्वालिटी कंप्रोमाइज किया गया है. स्टैंडर्ड्स जो MNRE के नॉर्म्स हैं और जो स्टैंडर्ड्स हैं वो मेंटेन नहीं हुए हैं साइट पे काम करते वक्त. सो लोकेशन इज नॉट ए प्रॉब्लम, ओनली द प्रॉब्लम इज सम ऑफ द वेंडर्स आर नॉट
How can we avoid such mishaps in the future?
Yeah, in fact, the first thing is we should not compromise on at least when we are talking about a 25 years life of a plant. Then the first thing is we should not compromise on any of the things, structure, panel, anywhere. The panel is the main thing, and which generates the. It gives the output, but at the same time, I like considering the ever changing the climatic condition, uncertainty of climatic condition. We should be very careful about the selecting and designing of structure as well. I think structure was the most ignored. Highly ignored this thing up till now, but I think now the people will have to take care of this and consider it as one of the very serious concerns.
The thing is, developer has to understand that there is a minimum price requirement into it. So instead of quoting some fancy numbers into the tariff part of it, which is making their life hell to bring the project costs down, they should do some at least minimum homework, what is going on into the market and what will be the basic minimum requirement for the design part of it. Which I think should now be standardized by the government also, because now, at least we have done 10 to 20 gigawatts of project. So country knows what is going on into the standard, and government should specify the standards out of it. So that the cost also should be maintained and the quality should be maintained in the project.
I would just sum it up in, there's a phrase in Hindi called Sasta Roy Roj. Manga roe ek bar. So it is just like that if you are not quality conscious for a project which has to last for 25 years, and then you cut corners in the quality as well as the design, you are bound to see these kind of situations. And I would say in most likelihood, insurance companies will not this kind of natural calamity, because they may very easily prove that this was actually a design lapse and not a natural calamity which has affected the planet. So I would really sympathize with the developers who have not done a good due diligence on the design as well as the execution.
See, in this case, clients have to come up with a thought instead of going for just for the prices. Clients also have to go for some quality product. I'm into this industry from past 6-7 years. What I have seen, जब पहले होता था हम प्रोजेक्ट सेल करते थे या हमने ऐसे भी क्लाइंट्स देखे हैं जिन्होंने पहले प्राइस कम करने के चक्कर में एक डी रेटेड कंपनी से या एक अच्छा क्वालिटी प्रोडक्ट के कंपैरिजन में एक इंफीरियर क्वालिटी का प्रोडक्ट खरीदा है. अब 2-3 साल में उन्होंने उस प्रोडक्ट को यूज किया. इफ वी टॉक अबाउट सोलर वाटर हीटर, सोलर स्ट्रीट लाइट्स, सोलर पावर सिस्टम्स, और उसमें वो अब बाद में खराब हो गया है. बट अगेन इफ द सेम क्लाइंट कम्स टू द मार्केट और बोलता है कि हमें फिर से वाटर हीटर लगवाना है, अब क्लाइंट बदल रहा है. क्लाइंट को समझ आ रहा है कि पिछली बार जो लगवाया था वो एक इंटीरियर क्वालिटी का लगवाया था पैसे बचाने के चक्कर में. अब जो नए क्लाइंट्स आ रहे हैं जिन्होंने ऑलरेडी ये चीजें झेली हैं और अब जो मार्केट में फिर से सोलर पावर पर ये इक्विपमेंट्स परचेज करने के लिए आ रहे हैं वो क्वालिटी देख रहे हैं. बट जो नए क्लाइंट्स हैं ना जो फर्स्ट टाइम अभी जा रहे हैं, अगेन उन लोगों के लिए मेरा सजेशन है इंस्टेड ऑफ गोइंग जस्ट फॉर द प्राइजेस, देखो प्राइजेस L2 में रख सकते हैं. पहले आप कम से कम L1 में, जब आप कंपनी सेलेक्ट करते हैं L1 में आप कम से कम क्वालिटी रखिए ना. एप्पल टू एप्पल कंपेयर कीजिए, उसके बाद प्राइजेस कंपेयर कीजिए. मार्केट में अभी क्या हो रहा है, क्लाइंट ये देखते नहीं है कि क्या क्वालिटी लगा रहे हैं, सिर्फ कोटेशन का प्राइजेस देखते हैं कि 50 रुपीज में ये दे रहा है और नेक्स्ट वेंडर 45 रुपीज में दे रहा है. बट दे डोंट कंपेयर इट कि 50 रुपीज में वो कौन सा ब्रांड दे रहा है, किस क्वालिटी का स्ट्रक्चर दे रहा है, किस क्वालिटी का सिविल वर्क होगा, वर्कमैनशिप क्या होगा, किस तरह का टीम काम करेगा. तो मेरा सजेशन है कि जो क्लाइंट्स हैं, क्लाइंट शुड बी अवेयर, तभी इस तरह का मिस हैपनिंग्स रुक सकता है.